Yesterday, the province announced plans to end OHIP coverage for people traveling abroad. Now, the payouts were never really all that much. On average, over the past 5 years, they amounted to about $127 per case. But the province says this move will save them over $11 million a year. Much of that money was being spent on administration costs. But Ontarians are losing peace of mind. And if you're planning on hitting an NFL game or going for a little bit of cross-border shopping, even just for the day, you may want to look into acquiring some travel insurance.
Take a look at the Detroit Medical Center. Last year, 51 unlucky Canadians walked through their doors for help. If you happen to be in town for a Lions game and break your leg, you could be looking at a $24,000 bill. An appendectomy could cost you more than $55,000. Chest pains? That's a $22,000 bill. And these are the types of emergency treatments that OHIP could no longer cover, even in part. Even now, they aren't paying much. Last year, more than 83,000 people submitted claims for out-of-country health care costs with an average bill of $2,500. Only 71,000 of those claims were paid, and the average payout, just $121. In a statement, a spokesperson for Health Minister Christine Elliott writes, with this limited coverage and low reimbursement rate, OHIP-eligible Ontarians who do not purchase private travel health insurance can be left with catastrophically large bills to pay. For this reason, Ontario continues to strongly encourage individuals to purchase additional travel health insurance so they are adequately covered every time they leave Ontario to travel abroad. But that could be easier said than done.
So let's say you want to go to Detroit. You don't want to spend the night. You just want to go catch a Lions game or a Tigers game or maybe do some shopping. But it's going to be a family affair. So you go online to try and get traveler's insurance. And we've got a group of people here aged 5 all the way up to 64. Well, you're looking at $98 just to get emergency medical coverage. That's $98 in addition to the cost of just going to the game. But if you're 65 years or older, and we saw this with many different insurance sites, you will actually have to fill in a medical questionnaire. You answer yes to any of those questions, in this case, diabetes, well, you can expect your rates to be considerably higher. In fact, in this case, the individual who is 65 years old, who sometime in their lifetime was diagnosed with diabetes, 1 day of travel just to do a little bit of shopping, $73.
The government acknowledges that dropping travel OHIP will lead to an increase in private travel insurance costs.
Now, the province is seeking public input on this, but you're going to have to be quick because you only have until April 30th to do so, and they haven't exactly made it easy for you to do so. You have to go to Ontario's regulatory registry, find the proposed changes, and then submit your comments. If passed, these changes come into effect on October 1st. At Queen's Park, Christina Howarn, City News.